When you hear the name Cummins, I can almost guarantee you think of a diesel engine. After all, that's what their entire business is built on. But what if I told you they're venturing into the world of hydrogen engines and could eventually replace their massively successful and long line of diesel engines? It sounds crazy. Why on earth would Cummins pursue hydrogen engines when their entire business is built on diesel engines, designing them, producing them, supplying them? They're all over the world. And yeah, it does sound crazy, but it's true. They actually are pursuing hydrogen engines. So let's get into it. And right off the bat, the question is why? Why would they pursue hydrogen engines? What is in it for them? Is there money to be made? Is there some sort of innovation that they have? What are they doing? And well, we're seeing more and more money day by day, year after year, more money being put into electric vehicle systems. Companies like Ford and other big automakers are putting tons of money into electric vehicle systems. And we know from the EPA's scheduled emissions restrictions that life for gasoline and diesel-powered engines is going to get very, very difficult, if not outright impossible, in the near future. And keep in mind, that's not to say that the free market is going to willingly choose electric over fossil fuel vehicles anytime soon due to pricing and range concerns, but rather that it's being forced by a branch of the US government. And because of that, we have seen electric and plug-in hybrid electric vehicles, also known as EVs and PHEVs, popping up left and right from just about every single automaker in the world. And while I will say vehicle electrification is totally fine for individuals who live in the city, don't have long commutes, and especially do not have to use their vehicles for work. So something like the Ford F-150 Lightning, it's not a particularly great work truck because of the range when towing and hauling. But what about people who don't live in the city? What about off-highway construction? What about over-the-road, long-distance trucking? There's a lot of applications where electric simply just doesn't make sense as of right now. Well, you might be thinking to yourself, yeah, well, we have electric semi-trucks coming soon. But there's a huge amount of work to be done before said electric semi-trucks are useful for long-distance hauling of goods. The massive infrastructure required simply is not there yet. That's not to say that it won't be there or can't be there. It's just simply not yet. Of course, it's also worth mentioning that lithium mining is incredibly destructive. Cobalt mining involves literal child labor in the Democratic Republic of Congo in some of the worst conditions imaginable. And the power required to charge vehicles is still being supplied by fossil fuel power plants. At least still partially here in the US, and in upcoming countries, it's almost exclusively supplied by fossil fuel power plants. And that still does not cover off-highway construction, where electric simply is just not a good option because of the location of where the work is being done. If you wanted to use electric vehicles for bringing materials in and out or electric machinery in an off-highway construction site, you'd likely need a very large diesel generator on site to supply the electricity for those vehicles, which kind of defeats the purpose. Seriously, don't underestimate the absolutely ridiculous amount of power required for an electric vehicle to operate. So that brings us back to the internal combustion engine. But as we mentioned, the EPA has scheduled emissions restrictions that are coming in the near future that are basically going to strangle gas and diesel engines. So if you want to keep the internal combustion engine in use, you have to switch the fuel source to something cleaner, which is exactly why Cummins has been putting money into hydrogen-powered engine solutions for on-the-road trucking, off-highway construction, and so on. And with something like a Cummins-powered generator, then you could more easily have the electrical generation required to power off-highway construction with electric vehicles bringing materials in and out, or just having electric construction equipment like an excavator and so on. Now, I don't mean to say that we're going to see electric excavators become incredibly popular anytime soon, as it likely won't happen for another 20, 30, 40 years, but you get the point. So that takes us to Cummins' two new hydrogen-powered engines, which are actually based very much on two diesels that already exist in Cummins' portfolio, which is the 6.7 liter that you can find in applications like the Ram 2500, and the 15 liter that you can find in applications like commercial trucks. And even more interestingly, Cummins isn't developing these strictly as hydrogen-fueled engines, but rather as fuel-agnostic engines that can be powered by either diesel or hydrogen, which then massively eases concerns regarding the lacking infrastructure required for a strictly hydrogen engine. They're doing this by using a shared common short block for both the diesel and the hybrid fuel engines. Everything from the head gasket down is just about the same, but everything from the head gasket up has to be changed for the new fuel type. And by sharing a common short block and as many components as they can, it not only makes development cheaper and easier, but it also makes it much easier to convert existing 6.7 liter and 15 liter engines over to the new hybrid fuel design in the near future, at least in theory. And on top of that, They're not even stopping there. This new fuel agnostic platform is also expanding to biogas fuel and HVO fuel, giving prospective buyers lots of options coming in the very near future. For now though, the big news and attention mostly lies on the hydrogen fuel engines, and well, part of the reason is because they're not exactly practical yet. And we've mentioned this in previous videos before talking about hydrogen engines, and we've seen thousands of comments from people all over the world saying that hydrogen is, quote, free to generate. But the thing is, you actually have to generate the hydrogen, which requires electricity, almost like you can't generate energy for free. You see, a lot of people will find YouTube videos about hydrogen generators and how you can plug one into your car. And don't get me wrong, that's very interesting. And I've even built multiple small hydrogen generators myself. But building an onboard hydrogen generator that can power a 6.7 liter or 15 liter engine simply isn't practical. It would be physically massive. So the other solution, if you want to have a large 6.7 or 15 liter engine powered by hydrogen, is by using liquid hydrogen. And in order to do that, you need to have an onboard storage tank or multiple onboard storage tanks. But there's only one problem. Hydrogen isn't a liquid, at least not until it's cooled to negative 423 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, obviously that in itself takes energy, and then the hydrogen won't stay in that liquid state as it heats back up, which then means you need to have a massively pressurized holding tank to keep it in that liquid state, which then means you cannot use your standard fuel tank. It has to be swapped out. We're not saying that a hydrogen-powered future is impossible, because that's far from what I'm trying to say here. I do believe hydrogen-powered internal combustion engines have a lot of potential, but simply that onboard generation isn't going to be easy with an engine this large. In fact, it's just not going to be possible as of right now, which means we're stuck with using liquid hydrogen, which then has its own sets of hurdles and obstacles to overcome. And on top of that, just one question here. If it takes electricity to generate hydrogen through electrolysis to then burn through a combustion engine, why not just use that electricity to power an electric motor connected to the wheels in the first place? That takes us right back to the start, but you get the point. There are hurdles that must be cleared for hydrogen-powered internal combustion engines to be adopted in mass. On the bright side, hydrogen-fueled internal combustion engines are actually very similar to compressed natural gas engines, which again simplifies the development process even further. And because the upcoming Cummins hydrogen-powered engines are based on existing Cummins diesel engines, it almost entirely eliminates the possibility of reliability issues, since existing Cummins diesels are incredibly reliable, or at least as reliable as it can be, given the emission systems that we know plague reliability. That means it can also bolt up to the existing transmissions and generators and so on. It can also use the same cooling systems and a bunch of components. It makes it much easier by using a shared platform. In this video here, put out by Cummins, you can see that the 6.7 liter hydrogen engine outputs an impressive 216 kilowatts and 1200 newton meters, which translates to 290 horsepower and 885 pound-feet of torque for us Americans who can't use the metric system to save our lives. And for Cummins, they believe that hydrogen-powered engines will be complementary to battery electric vehicles like buses and trucks, but that one powertrain type won't completely replace the other. As I mentioned earlier, there will be significant use cases for both types of engines, and I think that's exactly what Cummins is trying to prepare for. By not switching entirely to hydrogen, by not switching entirely to electric, they're diversifying their product lineup and preparing to offer products for a wide range of applications. So is the Cummins diesel segment dead? No, far from it. We're gonna see Cummins diesel engines produced for a very long time. And if they can massively clean up their diesel engines without adding even more reliability plugging emission systems by using something like, I don't know, ducted fuel injection or something to come up with some sort of innovation to help clean up their engines, we could see Cummins diesel engines being used for another 20, 30, 40, 50 years, depending on how they evolve. But with the upcoming EPA regulations, we know that that in fact might not be possible. So Cummins is preparing for the worst, and they're diversifying their product lineup by offering engines that can run on multiple different fuel sources by running on the same base engine. And it's also worth noting, it's not like Cummins is doing this on their own. There's actually a ton of different companies putting money into hydrogen-powered internal combustion engines. Over in Japan, companies like Mazda, Yamaha, Toyota, and Kawasaki have all banded together to develop hydrogen solutions. All of these companies compete with each other in some way, yet they're working together towards saving the internal combustion engine. Cummins is also working with various other companies to push this technology and make it a truly viable solution, because again, battery electric vehicles are simply impractical for long distance over-the-road trucking and off-highway construction, at least for now. And while this is all very interesting and very exciting, we likely won't be seeing either the 6.7 liter or 15 liter hydrogen engines enter production for quite a while. As per Cummins, the 15 liter engine will enter full production in 2027, and the 6.7 liter should be as soon as 2023. So what do you guys think? Do you think Cummins hydrogen engines will eventually replace their diesel engines, or will electric just simply take over and find a way to work for all of these different types of applications? In my opinion, the diesel engine still has a ways to go. It's still going to be used for quite a while because, as I mentioned, off-highway construction is a huge hurdle to clear for electric vehicles and is simply not going to be practical for a significant amount of time. The next decade, two or three, will have a lot of innovation in the automotive world, in the engine world, and we could see things change massively. So really, all we could do as of right now is just sit back and wait to see how this all unfolds. If you think there's anything I missed in this video or anything you want to add, be sure to drop it down in the comments below. Be sure to also let me know what videos you want to see in the future. While you're down there, smash the thumbs up button if you enjoyed the video because it really helps me out. Get subscribed so you don't miss out on future videos. Check out some of the other stuff on the channel. Check us out on Instagram and TikTok. We post a lot on there too. I'll see you guys in the next one.